game of the first semifinal of the day for Valor Series Europe. Guys, it's all you.
This is it. This is all on the line now for Team New. They need to rally here in game number two. And Sebka stepping forward. The stun is there. The entire side of Team Noob is there, already forcing out some early resources there for the side of Nova. And the early invade is there. This is exactly what they need to be doing. Nova is taking damage across the board right now. Team Noob decided this is a hero brawler now. We're going all in on our opposing team. And they are starting off with pressure. But in return, Crane's going to snipe out that blue on the other side.
Yeah, and that was a nice invade there by the side of Team Noob. But are they going to win the trade in general? And look at the heal coming out just in the nick of time. And are we going to see here? And Mina takes a tower shot and looks like Ruoma will secure the kill on that Wonder Woman right here.
That was a battle of inches. One tower shot, the heal coming in so clutch for the side of Team Noob, able to rally. I thought Nova was about to completely turn that. And I said, well, game number one all over again. But no. Team Noob coming up clutch in that situation there. They're going in, finding the invade onto the side of Nova. Of course, Nova going to trade out in response, though, on their side with that blue buff. So a bit of back and forth, but the first blood this time going over the way of Team Noob. And I definitely think they're feeling a little bit more confident in game number two with a more standard draft.
And they definitely need to continue this pressure because they have a jungle Ryoma. He is going to be significantly strong in the early and mid game of this game. Late game, he's going to fall off a little bit, but you can see the damage and the early game power of Ryoma with his passive, the Jitsu, and his Willing Blade stun. It does so much damage that he was able to get the blue buff and then converted that into a kill for the side of Team Noob. They just need to keep this aggression up and win these fights.
Sebka is such a threat up here in the top lane, but the turn from Pitch is here. The rotation from the side of Team Noob, beautifully executed. That was so clutch from the side of Team Noob right there. Zenyo being like, oh, you know, come attack me. I can't really beat you. Pulling a back, forcing him back. But wait, no, I have friends who show up in the situation. Crane is now forced to blow that ult in the mid game. This is, again, the mind games coming out from Team Noob in game number two. Much more what we expected here. But Nova, they are still in this. They are still kicking, only down by 1k gold. That's going to extend a little bit here, unless they can pull off a clutch snipe on the dragon. But I don't think that's in the cards for them. But now that we're seeing Nova just falling across the board right now, if they do find the pick on the Mina, they're not going to. This is the start that Team Noob needs.
Yeah, this is exactly what Nova did to Noob. And Noob's like, guess what? We're going to do it back to you. They are now ahead, almost 2k gold, 2 kills up. They got the first dragon. And now they just need to continue to starve and invade Nova so that they continue to abuse the early game that Ryoma provides, and that's exactly what they're doing right here.
So one thing I don't think we talk about, or at least highlight enough, is the individual play of some of these players. You talk about that solo lane matchup. Obviously, Omen is such an amazing duelist, but game after game, we are seeing Sebka just be a beast. Is he one of the best solo laners in EU? This guy is constantly on point with his skills.
Yeah, he is winning his side lane. He's giving his team a lot of breathing room, allowing them to rotate. Noob had to rotate onto him and kill him to shut him down because he was winning the trade against, because Zenyo will not win the duel against an Omen like that. So Noob needs to keep that up. But Sebka, if he continues to give his lane an advantage, that's going to open up a lot of playmaking ability for the side of Nova.
He just needs to not step forward once again, because we do have 0-9 coming in with another rotation here. Sebka is being forced back. But I love the fact that he's constantly forcing these responses to Team Noob. If he wasn't, imagine what else Team Noob would be doing elsewhere on the map. Exactly like you said, this is huge. These forcing the allocation of resources here from Team Noob. But that being said, Nova, again, not too far back, but again, a 2k gold lead. It's like we're seeing game number one, but in reverse.
Yeah, and look at that 4-minute rotation there by Team Noob. They three-man collapse right onto the Spirit Sentinel as soon as it spawns. This is the Team Noob that we know. They have these objectives on timers. They have the jungle on timers. And looks like they're going to get a free mid-tier one tower here from the side of Nova.
Well, defense, though, might actually be able to come in and deny that. I mean, that was almost just a quick tower here coming in. If that had been even a minute later into this game with a little bit more items, that would have been a very easy tier one turret here in the mid lane. But a good defense holding there for Nova. You could see they were mirroring the rotation in the jungle, but then, oh, wait, hang on, they're going back to the mid. And kind of shaking that up here is the side of Team Noob. But this is now the chance for Nova and crew to go in to die. 0-1 is going to try and snipe out this dragon. The whole team is rotating in. The taunt is there. The fall, can they get the damage? Yes, the Abyssal Dragon is sniped, but it is Nova taking a lot of damage in this engage. Oh, no, iFlex is trying to do his best here, but it is Team Noob just slicing and dicing the side of Novo. They stacked up beautifully. All the splash damage from Nuke, too much to deal with.
What a play by Crane. They're able to secure the dragon. However, they do give up two deaths over for one. And that, however, was a good steal from the side of Nova. So they're still in this game. They just need to continue to hold off and not give towers over. Again, Sebka is just making plays in side lane there. He was able to get the Slayer tier 1 tower, and that's going to give Nova a nice edge there instead of falling two behind.
Well, it's interesting because, you know, we always talk about the power of Xeniel to show up to these fights. Team Noob didn't even need him in this engage, still able to win this. Obviously, they lost the dragon, but they're able to secure themselves a couple kills here. But I talked about Xeniel going into this, and we always talk about how much they prioritize him. And obviously, his participation, but Jump crunching some numbers over here for us during the stream. Xeniel is coming into this in Europe with a 50% win rate. So despite the fact that teams seem to think he is so amazing, he's not actually coming out with some sort of crazy, impressive statistic to his name.
Yeah, Xeniel is you need to just get ahead, because when you're behind, it's really tough to win a lot of trades. But look at this. Vex is a little bit out of position, and he's going to get caught, but the Xeniel out comes out, and it does not save him time, and he gets killed.
That was not, I think, the execution that Team Noob was looking for. A beautiful defense, hugging that tower. If you saw that meme on Reddit the other day with the cat holding on to the things, defend me under my tower! It was just hilarious. So that's basically what's happening here in this game. But now it is, of course, the side of Nova. I mean, that's what they need to do. They need to hold. It is only 5-2. It is not the crazy dominant early game that we saw from Nova in game number one here. Team Noob, they're only ahead a few hundred gold here. Team Noob has rallied beautifully here. This is a close matchup. Both of these teams are rallying to be the best in Europe, and they are showing it now. Good play, good counterplay, and we see the fight starting to break out here potentially onto the dragon. Watch the rotations here. Xeniel's going to need to be careful because that ult might not yet be off cooldown here, so watch for that coming into this next engage. So this is going to be clutch here. If the side of Nova can get another dragon, they will actually surpass the gold advantage of Team Noob, and they will be looking solid in this early game.
Yeah, this
will
be huge. So they need to contest and potentially see this dragon here. And are they able to do it? No, they're not. And this is going to put Nova now in an even in terms of gold, close to Team Noob and not too far off. And this is really tough for the side of Team Noob because, as you know, Ryoma is going to start to fall off a little bit late game. And interesting, he built the attack speed War Boots there instead of Gilded Greaves. So it looks like he wants to be a more damage-dealing Ryoma to kind of use his attack speed to dish out a lot of damage, but that makes him extra squishy. So if Vex gets caught out, he's going to be in a world of hurt.
But Vex is definitely one of those playmakers time and time again. But speaking of making plays, Pitch is the one who has to try and make some plays to survive right here, as they are committing every resource to get this kill. He can't teleport to himself. And now Vex is here standing strong. The lifesteal, though, on that ult is doing so much work. The bait is real, though. No, he is going to fall. It is Nova, though, going to take 2-for-2 in this initiation so far. So a nice over 3-for-2. Oh, man. It's okay. In the end, Team Noob able to rally somewhat and then engage.
Yeah, they have to trade towers here because if Nubu is taking the top tower and they get a kill and a tower, and this puts Nova at a nice, nice positive net trade for them. And that, look at the gold lead. It's not even that big anymore.
Yeah, this is huge. I mean, we're having fights breaking out both sides of the map simultaneously. I feel bad for our observers because these guys are fighting on all fronts right now. We saw Pickoff going off in that top lane as well, simultaneously while the fight breaking out in mid. That's why I was confused. Like, wait, somebody else died in this engage. There we go. So we're seeing Team Noob and Team Nova multitasking like champs so far in the series. But, of course, as we start to look towards this late game, we can start to get some more kills. Points of contentions, win conditions, the Dark Slayer is here, and now teams are starting to move, look towards the side of the map because it's so much more impactful.
Yeah, this is key here. Whoever is going to be able to secure that Dark Slayer is going to have a huge advantage. They're going to open up a lot of map control because you can't really fight a team with Dark Slayer. And look at that! The collapse in mid is just going insane here.
As iFlex, though, is dishing out a lot of damage, but going down, he's paying for his greed there in the back line. All the while, Chognar is able to keep Vex and crew alive, but 07 and Sefkar going off there. It is Crane, who's also going to fall in the mid as well. So fights, as I said, breaking out left, right, and center, but it is actually Sefkar still chasing now Lubu in the top lane as well. Can he secure that takedown? Omen is such a threat, and no, in the end, Lubu is able to survive. Sefkar not able to secure that kill up there in the top lane as well. But look at the collapse from Team Noob there, isolating Mina. She's supposed to be the tank. She's supposed to be beefy there in that front line, but they melted her. You saw Zil go in, try to get the counter kill, was able to do that, but then overcommitted so much, he just got immediately ripped apart.
Yeah, Vex got so much AoE damage in that mid-level of the fight. Mina gets caught out. They just all focus her. They get a ton of kills, and then able to convert that into now significant tower lead for the side of Noob. That was a fight they needed to win, and now they just need to continue to pressure and win the objective game here and then secure the game early before it gets too late for Ryoma to make a difference.
Yeah, it is Nova making a stand here, pushing it into the mid lane under this tower. They're going to be able to take it down with easier, but the side of Team Noob is collapsing beautifully. There is the great taunt, the follow-up there, the damage. Breda is dishing out Dark in the back line. Well, nicely done executing there. 09 is now the target, and somehow Sepka lives with a scrap of HP. Crayon almost finding that lasso of doom, not lasso of truth in situation, as Poseidon almost ended up falling there. Look at the health bars from Nova. They escaped by the skin of their teeth there in that middle engage, and that just goes to show, when push comes to shove, they can shove.
Yeah, this is why Preda is so good, and she's being played so much in EU. That plague charge up, you basically force your opponent to make a decision. Do I try to secure the kill or run away and eat the damage from the Plague Spectre? And Team Noob decided to get hit by that Plague Spectre, and you see the amount of health bars just dwindle when that thing hits. It is so much damage, and the way that Nova is playing around the Preda is working out for them really well.
I think it comes down to it's sort of the unexpected nature of this, because if you end up taking the fight, you line it up with the taunt, you then follow up with the damage from Preda. I love this synergy, by the way. But then the second you execute that, suddenly there's a Zil there. Suddenly there's all this cleave, all this damage middle of the fight. You go from healthy, happy health bars to we're dead now. There is no middle ground. The burst damage from the side of Nova is impeccable, not really giving time for the heal, not Chognar to really do the work. The heal is not really going to be there or not going to be able to do enough. But another fight is now breaking out over the Dark Slayer, and Mina and crew are in full retreat. But here comes the Zenial in the back line. Pitches there, but Crayon is now standing strong against all the members in the back, though. Iflex going up against Poseidon. The Injurer is going to be there. Nicely done, and now it is Dark. Caught way out of position. They overcommitted in the back line. They're way too far. Nova overstepping, overconfident. The trades are here from both sides, but all the while, Sebka, the split push, both of these teams are going off.
And the way they collapsed there, Lubu just went in there and just zoned them out. And then Dart just put himself in such a bad position, going up and around, and then just basically getting collapsed on by the side of Team Noob. Instead of playing around Dart and the Preda, they fell prey to themselves. And Preda became the prey, got focused out, Zil went down first, then Preda. That secured them the fight. Now Team Noob is looking so good, and they can come back and hopefully secure this game, but they need to get that Dark Slayer.
Crayon just shut down that dream. He just went in and sold them out. They were trying to take the Dark Slayer, trying to multitask there as well, but Crayon just said, no, this Wonder Woman is such a threat. But look at this chart right now. This is it was close. It was kind of back and forth, but now the lead is starting to come up, but it's still not even that much. This game has been fairly neck and neck this entire game.
Yeah, so neck and neck. They need to have mental fortitude here. These games are going really long. A lot is on the line for Team Noob. They gotta stay focused. They gotta continue fighting as a team here, but they have to do something about the Preda. They need to have the Lubu come in there, zone out the Preda, so that they don't all bunch up and eat a fully charged Plague Spectre. This is the win condition they need to put. And if Zil, if Iflex decides to overextend, they need to get onto him and punish him, because Zil doesn't have that much defense, actually. If you look at the items on Zil and Preda, they are very, very squishy targets, and their goal is to blow one of them up immediately and turn this fight in their tie.
Yeah, they need to try and get that initial pick there. That's going to be huge. But one person that I haven't talked about a lot, but I think we need to focus on more here, is 09 on that Chognar. He needs to be denying the taunt every time in these fights. Every single time Mina goes in, 09 needs to make sure that he is in position to deny that, because if she's able to line it up, you've got a Preda there. It's going to be more than happy to just land that strike every single time as fights are breaking out across both sides. But the Dark Slayer is actually going down there, going to be picked up by the side of Team Noob. The zoning was beautiful from them. Omen constantly trying to split push. He actually ended up denying the rotation there from the Zenia, but it was still enough for the side of Team Noob to secure that. Their posturing was perfect in that initiation, and now Zenia at some point will be able to rotate up here now, but they have the Dark Slayer buff. They're pushing into this top lane. Such a closer game, but Nova is not out of this yet by any means.
No, not at all. They are going to lose their tier 2 tower in the top lane there, and look at the split pushing now they're forming up. This is exactly what Team Noob Team Noob needs to do to hopefully get more of these towers and put a massive amount of lead when it comes to objective.
Yeah, but what I really want to hear from Team Nova is to utilize their vision. The second they see Zenyal step too far or Chogdar in one direction, when they know that they have three members facing them, I need them to commit going in an instant. It's a bit of a windup on that Zenyal. He takes a second to get there, so they need to make sure that they go in and try and find that crucial pick. Again, I'm watching for Y0.
Yeah, I love how Nova did this thing, and now Team Noob did it. They basically proxy the wave and don't let the wave even touch against and stop their mini wave. And as soon as the red wave comes, they immediately jump on that tower, and that tier 2 tower is gone. So now what they need to do with the split pushing Zenyal is doing here, they need to have both waves crash and focus on one of the towers where Nova is not focused their entire team. So the mid-ground tower is going to be a little risky here. Let's see how this plays out.
They're going in. The Chogdar ult is there. The Zenyal to follow. The damage from Preda and the side of Nova is trying to escape, but there's just too much damage coming from the side of Team Noob, but they are fighting it underneath this tower. The tower is going to go down, though, so a nice recovery here. Look at the damage, though, coming out from the side of Nova. They are trying to stabilize, but the damage has been done. Team Noob able to get that high ground tower, and Pitch is still alive here up against Vex. They're going for Dark, and then by the takedown there. Yes, they do! Pitch and Ibex are going off here in the mid lane, but iFlex is a couple juicy targets in front of him, but he doesn't want to overextend. He saw what just happened to Wonder Woman.
What a nice play by Zenyal there. He had Ancestral Glory. It revived him, got back in a fight. Ryoma then waited for them to waste their abilities onto the Zenyal, who had his shield up, protected him, and then he was able to get both those kills. What a way to turn it around. That was a super risky dive by Team Noob, but they do get the high ground tower in the middle there, which puts them ahead. This now will spawn a super minion down the middle, and that puts extra lane pressure in the mid lane against the side of Nova.
I mean, Team Noob, I wasn't sure about that engage. Chognar just decided this is the stance, and they ran in, committed fully onto that. Somehow were able to beautifully split the damage there between the tower, between the key priority targets. And again, they ended up giving some of that life, but because of Ancestral Glory, they're able to get back into that. The Zenyal fully committing there, just having that heal, having that damage reduction, of course, having Chognar. The support from the side of Team Noob is impeccable, just allowing Tulin to do that damage, and you cannot negate the Lubu, the Ryoma in these fights, but really the supports are the stars right now on the side of Team Noob. Those guys are putting on a clinic.
Yeah, and you see what they have item-wise. Nova, they don't have a lot of magic defense. I mean, Gilded Greaves does give some magic defense, but Tulin is going to be doing a lot of damage because only Omen has the Medallion of Troy to counter the damage coming from the side of Tulin there. So if they don't focus down Tulin, and the amount of AoE damage he does, that's going to be something that's going to be difficult for Nova to handle if they want to dive and try to kill to Ryoma or someone.
But look on the other side. Speaking of magic resistance going up against Dark there, I feel like Team Noob got the memo on that one.
Yeah, they have to. Against the Praetor, that Medallion of Troy and that shield that it gives will absorb the damage from one Plague Spectre, which it will give them enough time to survive and hopefully be able to kill the Praetor or Zil. Because look at, you have Zil and a Praetor. That's two heroes that have a ton of magic damage and burst. So Medallions of Troy on the side of Team Noob is perfect to counter that.
Yeah, but up in the top lane as well, potential 2v1 fight breaking out here, and again the split push of Team Noob as they are forcing this fight in the bottom line as well. But we don't see again that marksman coming in, the traditional ranged ADC, going to be able to really just focus down these towers, because there's a few shots that they'd had that hero in that situation, maybe could have started to chunk that down a little bit more. So this is maybe a downside of this composition here when it comes to these long drawn out sieges, as we do advance now towards the late game where we start seeing the six stacks coming out, the items are starting to come in, but still Nova has a lot of room here to still round out these builds. So Team Noob still has a chance to utilize this gold league.
Yeah, exactly. But you can see Preda is just so good at clearing out waves. I mean, it's so hard to dive a tower against a Preda. The Preda just cleans the wave so quickly. And look at that. Nova is doing a really good job of basically clearing out these waves before they can even touch and damage to this tower. And the way they're playing defense and turtling is working out really well for them right now.
Yeah, but if at some point they're going to have to pull the trigger. And we saw Team Noob do it before, but they're just starving out the side of Nova right now. The Dragon is back up. They'll probably rotate on that at some point. But they're playing out this late game now as the Dark Slayer will start to come back online here shortly. That buff will be crucial here for these teams, as it now is 1 minute out. So watch for that to be the point of contention. If Team Noob can secure that Dark Slayer, if they can get that buff, that's when they look for the fight. Nova needs to not let that happen. A win condition has just popped up on the map. They need to respond.
Yeah, they definitely need to. I love the itemization from Lu Bu and the side of Zenio. Preda built Zidehander, which is a magic attack speed item, and they have Shield of the Lost, which reduces attack speed. Look at this fight happening right here.
Yeah, the Zenio ult is going to go in. They're going to join the fray, but in the back, Lu Bu is zoning the team beautifully, which means Krayan is out on an island, going to be isolated and destroyed. 0-7 creating so much space for his team as Y01 is going to be the next target to fall up. The lockup is there. Look at the damage coming in from Team Noob. They are isolating their targets with grace and distinction, but somehow Nova is actually rallying here. But 0-7 with one more. No, he's going to fall. The tower is there. The Ancestral Glory is going to be getting so much value as the side of Team Noob is pushing now back in onto this high ground. But Nova will have the ability to heal up and try and reset these fights. But Zepka needs to be cautious in the mid lane because the minions are there going to be trying to deny those as best he can. Yes, which means the push onto the core is going to be vastly reduced here. But we do have minions. They are going to be trying to wail away on this core. But Dark is doing so much damage. But no, added Zepka down. And with that, that is going to be GG. Game number two is going to go over the way of Team Noob, which means, guys, we're seeing game number three here in our first EU semifinal.